only Son, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish but receive everlasting life. You see, God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the whole world might be saved through him. There are many different religions in this world, and it seems to me that people seem to think that if you join, you know, the Catholics have their way of salvation, Muslims have their way of salvation, Jews have their way of salvation. Every single way is different. And it works for one person, but it doesn't work. There is one God. There is only one God. That's the God of Israel. That's the same God that sent Moses into Exodus when he told Moses to bring the Jewish people into this land. That's the only true God. And his way of salvation is true for everybody. If you believe, well, it doesn't matter who you are, what race you are from, the same way of salvation is true for everyone. It is not one way for you and another for somebody else. There is one way of salvation, and his name is Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. Every single human being in this world is a sinner by nature. The Bible says that because of Adam's sin, God has given Israel over to the curse. And God is a holy God. And because of his holiness, he's not just going to let us into heaven in our sinful state. And because of his righteousness, and because every human has sinned against him, he's going to judge us all the same. And because of his justice, he has condemned us all. Every single one of us on the day of our judgment are going to stand before him guilty of sin. If you tell lies, lust, pride, idolatry, all of these things come from within, and they separate us from God. They defile us. And so, but God is a loving God. And because of his love for us, he sent his Son into the world to die for us, so that we could receive salvation. You know, you don't join church if you want salvation. It's not about joining religion. If you want salvation, if you want to go to heaven, if you want to receive eternal life, then you have to be born again. You have to be circumcised in your heart, which is a supernatural condition, which is a supernatural work of God. Only God can do that. And it comes by faith in Yeshua. Leviticus 17 verse 11 says that it is the blood which is the atonement for your soul. It is one way of salvation. And it isn't by joining church or religion or doing works. Nobody can get to heaven by being a good person, because there is none who are good. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. The only way of salvation is through faith in Yeshua. Zechariah chapter 12 verse 10 says that the day you look on him who you pierced is the day that the Spirit of grace will be poured out upon you, and all your sin will be forgiven. You see, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, came from heaven 2,000 years ago. It is written in the scriptures that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem, that he would come from Ancient of Days. And then on the third day when he was crucified for our sin, he was resurrected from the dead. It was witnessed by all his apostles. They all witnessed the death, burial, and resurrection.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeshua is Elohim, that he died for your sin,
talking about Yeshua.
Okay.
I don't have any literature.
So you can't just say that in order of trying to get what you want. Yeshua is alive. And he's the Jewish Messiah. And he's the only way of salvation. He's the only one that can save you. He's the only one that can deliver you from your sin. Your sin separates you from God. And Yeshua came 2,000 years ago to die on the cross for your sin, to reconcile you back to God.
Yeshua is coming back soon. Cry out to him and you shall be saved. God bless.